That's live. That's live. Keep that light. That's pretty good. It looks dark in there.
Good.
Yeah, that's good. Hey, everybody. Good evening. Good morning. How's everybody doing today? Hope everyone's doing great. It's, what is it, Wednesday night? Wednesday night. What would Jeff do? Q&A. We moved it to Wednesday night because we weren't around on the other nights, so we had to do it. My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. How are you? How's everybody doing? We're back from Linda has a new company. Go to her Facebook page. Go to her website. Live this way.
My Facebook page, definitely, or my website.
Which give that out.
Which is
LindaGellman.com.
LindaGellman.com. Okay. It's theconfidentfashionista.com. And you can also look up the Confident Fashionista on Facebook.
That's a hard word to spell, fashionista, isn't it?
If you got past third grade, maybe.
That's why I can't spell it. All right, so what we do is we do Q&As. So what we're going to do is you ask your dog training questions. I'll answer them if you're not familiar with who I am, what I do. Again, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I've got a dog training company up in Providence, Rhode Island. We specialize in aggression, rehab, behavior modification, but we also do everything else from an 8-week-old puppy up. We also do trick training. We do agility. We do basic obedience. We do on-leash and off-leash obedience. We can help you raise your puppy. We can prevent you from going to a boarding training like what we do. So it makes it a big difference. So I do these free shows as well as put out tons of other information out there because we're killing way too many dogs. If you're not familiar with how we work, we do a ton of praise, but we also do punishment. And the reason why we talk about punishment, and punishment is not abuse, that conversation should stop, is because most people on this show will ask me, how do I stop? How do I stop? How do I stop this? How do I stop that? How do I stop this? And that's why also dogs are turned into shelters and dogs are rehomed, because they wouldn't stop a bad behavior. So most dogs are not turned away because they do a great sit or they didn't do a good down. It's because they wouldn't stop a dangerous or a bad behavior. And that could be something as simple as, you know, pulling on the leash or jumping, obviously growling and biting and separation anxiety and, you know, all of those things. So you can hear me talk about punishment a lot. But in the scope of your average day at our training center, now people are not idiots at all, and we won't have any of that shaming there. So let's be careful on that. DJ, love you, buddy, but let's be careful. All right, let's go.
Hi, Jeff. Ecollar and invisible fence collar at the same time.
I'm not an invisible fence. Don't worry about it. I didn't ban you. So if you heard me say that, that means you're still on the show. So I didn't block you. You can, because they both have different, you know, they both have different purposes. Your invisible fence collar is going to keep your dog in the perimeter of your house, but your remote collar can help you with all your off-leash recall. So yes, they can be worn together. Next.
How to pick a protection dog puppy, what to look for, and what is a red flag?
I would actually go to a specific breeder for that, and I would actually talk to sport dog or personal protection trainers for that. I wouldn't talk to me about that because that's not what we do. That's not what we do. But if you're looking for a true protection dog, you definitely don't want to ask me about it or your average dog trainer. You absolutely want to talk to somebody who specializes in it. And also, you want to make sure that you don't talk to – sport dog is different from protection. So it all depends on what you're looking for. Next.
Your videos and social media posts have saved so many dogs. Thank you.
Oh, thanks, Dawn. Next.
Hope and Beth say hi.
Oh, hey, Hope and Beth. How are you?
I have a dog aggressive German Shepherd after being attacked by another dog. Any tips on how to help?
Yeah, that happens all the time, Brittany. What happens is when now your dog is being reactive and your dog is going, I'm going to go after you before you come after me. What I would do is I would teach that to start by using equipment that I feel is proper, that you can have a proper conversation with your dog. So prong collar, remote collar. Teach your dog how to better properly walk next to you. Use the remote collar to start as soon as your dog starts getting aroused. So start looking for arousal. What happened is, unfortunately, your dog has lost faith in you. Don't take it personally, but that's just what happened. You couldn't keep your dog safe. Don't worry about it. It's happened to me as well. My dogs have been attacked by off-leash dogs before as well, and it does set training back, and it does make them more reactive. So what you need to do is you need to tell them in a way that they understand, don't worry, I got it. How do you do that? As soon as you start seeing arousal from the dog, ears up, chest out, body posture, going from to closed mouth, any intense staring. What you want to do is you want to do is you want to correct that and then get your dog to be a little bit behind you and in a calmer state. Next.
I've got a fearful pup. I've tried getting her in new spaces, climbing up on playground equipment.
So what you can do with a fearful pup is, number one, hold your dog accountable. Hold your dog accountable. Don't baby the fear. Don't reinforce the fear. Lots of obedience. You can do trick training with a dog. You can do anything from food-based protocols. But believe it or not, a remote collar is a fantastic tool for a fearful pup. It is a fantastic tool. Hold your dog accountable is probably the best thing. Breaking through the dog's fear, you actually can use fear by breaking through the dog's fear. I gave a great example of actually Angelo swimming this weekend, if you follow me on Instagram stories. I'll probably do a whole Facebook Live on that because Instagram stories disappears in 24 hours. Next.
Hi, what happened to the ambassador dog from Hawaii? Thanks for all you do.
We have a lot of ambassador dogs from Hawaii. Right now we've got one in particular, Tux, who is great. Great. We're just looking for a specific home. We've adopted about, I don't know, not a ton of them, less than 10, but we have two dogs right now for adoption. Next.
Dog runs when I pick up Bonker. Should I still hit him with it even though he's scared?
Yeah, you still throw it at the dog. So you can throw it at the dog. It's got to be inevitable. So all punishment has to be inevitable. But hopefully your word no is, you know, remember, you don't bonk forever. Just like you don't have to do food training forever. Your word no should stop the behavior. Your word no should stop the behavior. If the dog is still doing the bad behavior, all right, if your dog is still doing the bad behavior, then you actually haven't properly punished to eliminate the bad behavior. Next.
Dog pulls a bit when wife and kids come along with stroller on walk. Stronger prong correction, okay?
Stronger prong correction. There's a 180 move that I do. If you go into my YouTube channel, just type in 180. It's me working with a Rottweiler. Also, remote collar healing is going to dramatically help you. It's not uncommon for the dog to try to move up a little bit whenever there's family involved. But what you need to do is you need to get your dog to move back a little bit. And it's actually not the worst thing in the world either if your dog moves up a little bit. Next.
When I'm correcting an unwanted behavior with an e-collar, should I say no at the same time?
You can say no first. No, and then there's a latency period. Could be 1 second, and then correction. Next, or punishment. Next.
Dog tends to be stubborn when I ask for a down. I dial up with e-collar, but problem continues. Thanks.
So it's not stubborn. It's lack of communication. So what's going on is the bottom line is this. If your dog could down fast for food, your dog could down fast in general. So what I would do is there's a specific way that I do down with remote collar. Once a dog has a full understanding of the command, you've done down hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of times, then it's time for a correction for noncompliance. It's just the way it is. You don't want to just reward for doing it. At some point, you've got to correct for not doing it. So once a dog understands the command, whatever the basic command is, what you can do is you would say down if the dog refuses to. You would do a higher remote collar correction because the dog understands what you're asking for. So you don't punish on obedience for a dog that doesn't understand, because the punishment will make a difference. You would punish for other things such as getting in the trash, jumping up on counters, but not for obedience. Next.
I don't want to pay $40,000 for a puppy for protection dog.
Nobody pays $40,000 for a puppy for protection dog. You'd pay $40,000 for a trained, fully trained adult dog, but for a puppy, you are going to pay under $5,000. You can actually pay under $1,000. Again, like, I'm the wrong guy to talk to. I'm the wrong guy to talk to. Next.
How to stop dogs from barking when someone knocks or doorbell rings?
You would teach the dog what no means. You can use a remote collar or a bonker. A bonker is just a towel wrapped up. Just go to YouTube and look up bonker. Gary Wilkes, he's got lots of videos on that. So it would be no, then you throw the bonker, or no, and use a remote collar correction. I don't mind dogs barking once or twice when the doorbell rings. Next.
How do you feel about Schutzen? Don't know if I spelled that right.
Schutzen, actually, they're calling it IPO now. It's a great sport. It's a fantastic sport. It is a sport. That's exactly what it is. It is an equipment sport. So dogs are trained on equipment, but it teaches a lot of things. It teaches, the skill of the dog, the courage of the dog. There's a lot of different protocols for it. I think it's a great thing. I personally don't do it, but I think it's great. Next.
GSD flattens his ears when I pick up the bonker and stops the behavior. Is he scared or is it working?
Probably both, but let's call it working. So if the dog stops the behavior, I'd like the dog to stop the behavior with the word no, though. So let's do no. I don't want you to pick up I don't want you to pick something up as a threat. I'd rather you have the dog, it would just be no. I want no to stop the behavior. But it's working. You're getting there. That's the big thing. Oh, a super heart. Thanks for that super heart. L Hog. Appreciate it. Yep. And also, if you don't know what tapping the screen is how I get hearts. It's just, you know, it's just sharing the love. And super hearts are a lot of fun. Super hearts eventually will be actually to monetize those. Next.
Starting prong collar, training on 8-month-old pup, but he'll object and just lie down. Best advice.
Jonathan, watch my prong collar dance. What you're going to do is, what I want you to do is, your dog is just saying, I don't like this. It doesn't mean it's hurting the dog. It doesn't mean the hurting dog. That's your dog saying no. That's all that is. Okay. That's your dog saying no. That's all it is. All right. So what I want you to do is what you're going to do is take your leash and if I don't get your questions right away, it's because I see things coming up on the screen, but Linda asked me the question. So right now we got 30 questions in the queue. So what you're going to do is, I want you to go, so sort of head north with a little bit of leash pressure, then head south with a little bit of leash pressure, go east, go west. It doesn't have, in other words, you're just going every which way with your dog, trying to get your dog to move. Next.
Remote collar makes my boxer flip out. Any advice?
Flip out in a good way or a bad way? If it's in a good way, that's great. If it's in a bad way, you might have introduced it to the dog improperly. I've got a very specific way on how I introduce remote collars to dogs, and it's with food, and it's layered over current obedience. Next.
Dog refuses to heel next to me. She wants to heel in front of me. Prong doesn't work.
Lisa, because there's training involved. In fact, I'm going to do a Facebook Live on this as well. I've got a couple of Facebook Lives backed up. Tools don't train the dog. So if I gave you a remote collar and you put it on your dog and you ask your dog to do stuff and you just push buttons, your dog wouldn't do it. Same with a prong collar. So just putting the prong collar on the dog is not going to make the dog heel, sit, down, recall, or place. There still has to be the training components. So the tool, though, definitely helps, absolutely helps communicate the training protocols to the dog. It makes it so much easier for the dog and also for the owner, and I'm all about making life easier for both. What I want you to do is start giving information to the dog through the leash, through the collar, earlier than you think. Don't wait till the dog gets even a little bit ahead. I want you to give that dog, it'll be heel and pop when the dog is starting to even think about getting ahead. Also, watch my 180 video. That'll get you going. Next. By the way, I offer free Skypes. If you go to my Facebook page, if you click on, there's all these different tabs, click on free Skype, you can schedule one. It's an automatic process. I actually do paid Skypes too. That's how I make a living. But you can do free Skypes. All these answers are like 15 minute to 60 minute answers, and I'm all doing them in 15 seconds. Next.
What if a dog is fearful of things coming overhead, like she thinks things are going to fall on her?
Well, you can counter condition that if you want to. You can do clicker food training for that. You can do that. You start out with things going next to the dog, and if they've got a calm reaction, no reaction, click and reward, turn it into a game. Next.
I am working with my GSD with remote collar, but also has prong collar on that is attached.
Okay, cool. That's fine. I don't know if that's the second part of a question, Angela, but that's allowed. Next. But don't attach it to the remote collar. The remote collar should always be freestanding. Nothing should be attached to it at all. Next.
My dog growled at food bowl. How to fix this?
I've got a video on resource guarding. I've got a bit on my YouTube channel. It's all punishment based. So what I want you to do is watch that video. I teach the out command. It takes 3 seconds. And dogs are killed in shelters for resource guarding. Death. Dead. Less than 24 hours. Dog growls. It's a dead dog. So I fix it in 3 seconds. So I'm very, very specific on how I fix it. Watch the video on YouTube. Next.
How do you teach a dog to relax and lay down calm instead of panting?
Jesse, what I want you to do is, well, the dog might be overheated. That's why it's panting. That's how dogs cool down. But also is what you're going to do is teach the place command. Teach the place command, and you're going to do duration. So you do duration work. Next.
Oh, to another – that was the last question about prong collar on at – same time as e-collar?
Yeah, the prong collar can be connected to another collar, but the remote collar should not be connected to anything at all. Next.
He will stop when I say no, but then do the same thing later. Harsher correction?
I'm not sure what that's connected to, Delilah. But if the dog's not understanding it, it could be a harsher correction. It could be lack of information of the knowledge that the dog understands what to do. Chances are, though, don't nag the dog in general. Don't nag. All right? So if it feels like you're nagging the dog, don't nag the dog. Next.
Is it worth going to the dog shelter, or will I get heartbroken? I'm scared I won't find the right dog.
Julie, go there and use your head, not your heart. So this is the thing about animal shelters. You know, this is the thing about animal shelters. You know, dogs die. We're killing 4 million dogs. They die. They die in shelters and they die at the vet office. That's just the way it is. What I don't want you to do is this. I want you to go to the animal shelter, and I don't want you to fall in love with all these dogs. Okay, I want you to use your head. I want you to use your head. So what I want you to do is I don't want you to use your heart. It sounds cold and uncaring, but I'm trying to save you tons of money and inevitable heartbreak farther down the road. So you go in there with an idea of what kind of dog you're looking for, what size and what energy level. Do that, okay? Don't be like, oh my God, I fell in love with this dog. It's like, if you fall in love with something that quick, really? Like, it's not a pair of shoes. It's a freaking living, breathing animal. So what I want you to do is go in there. It's going to suck, though. It's going to suck. Like, all these dogs are in cages. They're all making noise, usually. They might look sad. They might look scared. They might look happy to see you, and you're going to walk out, and you might want to save them all. But you know what? You can't. So go in there with, like, head. Next.
My dog lived with no neighbors, and we moved where homes are close by, barking at all things.
So, Angie, what I want you to do is this, is shut your dog up, obviously, which is why you asked the question. So give your dog a remote collar, and it would be, well, that's when you're home, and then you would say no, and you would give the dog a correction. So no, and it's an electric collar. So call it shocking, call it correcting, call it whatever you want. It's the dog's not dying. It's not a shock. It's not sticking your finger in an outlet. Is it uncomfortable? Yeah, it's uncomfortable. It's supposed to be uncomfortable. That's why dogs stop bad behaviors. Like, let's be real here. Like, human step. If I grabbed your boobs and you kicked me in the balls, I'm gonna stop grabbing your boobs unless I was into that. You know, and then I'd probably, you know, you'd probably charge me $100 and you'd be dressed in leather and like we'd have a contract written out in a safe word, but that's a whole other story. So what I want you to do is this, is bottom line is make it uncomfortable and suck for your dog. Next.
Have a question about T3 and also possibly bringing my dog. Best to do a Skype or email?
Kiki, do an email. Yes, you can bring your dog. Next. So the remote collar should be on super snug. Next.
Hi, okay to bonk older dog when too rough with 9-week-old puppy?
Sue, absolutely. But what I would do is I would do a little bit more. Be careful, though, you don't startle the puppy as well. Be really careful about that. I would use a dressage whip on that older dog's butt, to me, because that would then be focused just on the older dog and wouldn't affect the nine-week-old puppy. Because when you use a bonker, it's no, the word no, and then you're also throwing the then you're throwing the bonker. I don't want it to hit the puppy, and I don't want it to say no really to the puppy for doing nothing. Next.
Opened crate and walked away. Later, my dog was still in there. I realized I forgot to release her. LOL.
Good for you. It's impressive, Rami. Next.
My dog is toy obsessed and will growl if you try to take it. Would you collar one?
Lisa, that's not obsessed. That's being resource guarding. That's resource guarding. It might be obsessed too, but yes, remote collar. I want you to teach the out command from your dog. And I've got a video on that. Next.
Dog runs after cats. Once running, blows off level 100 on mini education.
So Steve, number one, make sure your remote collar is super, super snug. Make sure it's fully charged. Make sure it's either here or over there. And then also what I want you to do is you might actually need to get a higher level remote collar. There's some trainers out there saying, oh, if you can't train the dog on a mini educator, you're not training right. Bullshit. That's ridiculous. You might have to go up to the boss. If your dog's got like a high pain threshold and a high enough drive, they're going to do it. But I also want you to do is at the first sign that dog starts getting aroused, boom, high level. Squash it. Eliminate it. What you might be doing is chasing. You might be chasing. So what you could do is have it 100, but also the dog might be running away from the stim. So at the beginning, keep that dog on a long line. Keep the dog on a long line and try to set it up. Next.
Thank you and love you. Can 2 to 3-year-old help with come, sit, break training 6-month-old pup?
Absolutely. Use the dog's daily kibble. That's a great exercise for children. And you can also add place into that too. Next.
Client has 2 dogs, 4 years old, littermate syndrome. Train separately. What else?
Train them separately. A lot of structure into that. Crate them separately as well. And a lot of structure into that family's life. Next.
GSD seems to always want to be with me. I keep him in a 6x10 most of the day. He's a bit whiny.
So, Manny, what's happening is a 6x10, you got to crate the dog, number one, but teach place. So place is this. So my dogs are with me, but they're over there. One of them scratching her ear. But they're okay. So they're with me, but they're over there. So your dogs can still be with you, but it's like, hey, go lie down over there. So you can do that. Next.
Thanks for not blocking me. If you're ever in the New York area, please meet me and observe my operation.
Oh, DJ, sounds great. Thanks for reaching out. I appreciate that. That was nice of you. I used to be in New York all the time. I used to go to Brooklyn all the time. I actually had a little location in Brooklyn. I get a ton of New York City business, Brooklyn business, Queens, New Jersey business. I would love it. I can live in New York. I can do New York. I will. Okay, here we go. I will have a residence in New York City at some point in my life, or Brooklyn. I will live there at one point. Maybe not full time. I'll probably Airbnb it out, even though you're not allowed to, but I'll do it. Next.
Why do dogs always race to the door when the doorbell rings? It's hardly ever for them.
You know what? Probably because they believe in Santa Claus and they don't think that Santa Claus comes down chimneys, and they think Christmas is every day. Next. Yeah, I had a place right in Park Slope. Next.
Okay. Dogs rock it with the e-collar on, but when she's not wearing it, she blows well-known commands.
I know, because you haven't worked your dog hard enough on it yet, long enough on it yet, and you possibly have not, well, maybe you have, possibly have not gone to correction level yet, punishment level yet. So how long have you been working with this on your dog, on the remote? 6 months? A year? How consistent are you with it? How often does the dog wear the collar? Do you take it off, you know, all the time? Do you only put it on for certain things? Do you only put it on for training? Or do you put it on in the morning and then take it off at night? That's what you want to do. Wake up, put on your training equipment, go to bed, take your training equipment off. Next.
We found a stray about 2 years ago. He isn't good with kids. Is there any way we can make him be?
Yeah, Amanda, yeah. I mean, you've had 2 years. You've lost 2 years of training time. Don't worry. I'm not shaming you at all. But how far can we get your dog to be good with kids? I have no idea. Can we get your dog to be better? Yes. But then we also have the children factor. So will it always be management? It might be. It might be. I don't trust most kids though. So the best thing we would do is get your dog to be around children and not react to the children. But then we've got to advocate for the dog and keep kids away from your dog. I have no idea how far we can go, but yes, we can make it better. Next.
Best way to introduce dogs to each other?
Ideally, it's off leash. You start by migrating, structured walk. Then you can do things such as place. Then you can do things such as structured socialization, which we have videos of and we do at our training center. But do not allow them to meet on leash like that. Next.
Thanks. You're awesome.
Oh, Hannah, thank you. You're awesome.
Jeff, found you 3 weeks ago, changing my life. Dog stays in place, just me, breaks upon seeing fam.
Rob, excitement. It's excitement. So what it is your dog is aroused and excited. So keep your dog on a leash, and then when the dog gets excited and breaks command, it would be no leash correction. Next.
Pointer completely off-leash trained thanks to you, but still afraid of things in the house, boxes, etc.
Rich, congratulations, number one. I want you to go to Clicker Food Protocol to overcome the fear. Next.
You helped my foster dog in UK. Reactivity, improved, loads, doesn't go mad now, but still whines at dogs.
So Chrissy in the UK, love you. What I want you to do is remote collar, get rid of the whining. Next.
How to stop whining in the crate at night.
Normally we don't use remote collars at night, but for you, with any crate nonsense at night, remote collar on, whine, hit the do not whine button. Next.
Aloha, missed you all.
Oh, aloha, CJ. By the way, I've got a remote collar seminar coming up in 2 weeks in Providence. If you go to rvdogtrainer.com, rvdogtrainer.com, it's a seminar. I do 20-something seminars a year around the world. Belgium, we are announcing. It's official. We just haven't announced it yet. So we've got Scotland, England, and Belgium in April of 2018. I'm doing that with my buddy Sean O'Shea. Then I do the other RV dog trainer. I do 20 of those in North America, and I do those solo. Next.
Thank you, Jeff. Love you and your wife.
Oh, Julie, thanks. Cool.
How tight is the remote collar supposed to be?
Super tight. Next.
4-month-old GSD yelps and lies down, refusing to move with prong collar dance.
Sean, yeah. Isn't that a pain in the ass? This is what I want you to do. This is what I want you to do. How does your dog do it with just a regular martingale collar? Regular martingale collar. How does the dog do? Try that. Also use food. So this is what I would do. I would do the martingale collar and the remote collar and the prong collar on. And it's almost clutch and gas at the beginning. And what I want you to do is I want you to use a lot of food. Use the dog's daily food. And I want you to use some excitement too. So with 16-week-old puppies, I'm not, the video doesn't show me all excited, but with a 16-week-old puppy, I think his name is Sean, I do tons of excitement. All right, let's go. Good job. Come on, puppy. I do a lot of that. All right, next.
I can put prong collar on, but it seems tight. When I add a link, it does not stay in place. Is it better tight or loose?
Jesse, I go make sure it's up super, super snug. Make it a little bit snug. Next.
Linda, thanks for all you do. So many of us can get so much info. Thank you.
Thanks, Beth.
It's so nice. Thanks. We'll be starting on remote collar next week.
Awesome, Sue.
When you say snug collar, should I be able to get a finger under the collar or no?
Depends on what you're talking about. The remote collar, barely. I want it at the beginning. I want it super snug because if the contacts don't reach, you don't get any into the skin. You don't get any connection. If your dog passes out, it's too tight. So always remember that. Dog passes out, too tight. Next.
One of my employees' dogs bit a kid in the face, and they are suing me. How many bites before euthanasia?
Ah, God. That's a New York State lawyer, insurance company, family question. I don't know, man. I don't know. One of your employees' dogs bit a kid in the face while it was in your training center? Yeah. Hopefully you got insurance. If you don't have insurance, DJ, now's a good time to do it, but I'm sure you do. Probably don't want to talk about any of this actually on social media, just to give you a heads up, because these are all saved. It just sucks. It sucks. I feel for you. It sucks. This is the thing. It was an accident, most likely, and it sucks, and it's part of our business, and, you know, nobody, like, it just sucks. Nobody wins, and I really feel strongly that, you know, I'm not going to keep it going. Next. Yes, I work with fearful, insecure dogs at the RV seminar. It is a great place for a fearful, insecure dog in my seminar. You would think it wouldn't be, but it's the best place for your dog to go. I will unleash that dog in a weekend. Next.
How do I have a structured walk and let the dog pee or poop? Should they be different walks?
Oh, Julie, no. When I say structured walk, that means when you're walking, you can then take pee-poop breaks. So can your dog. So what you can do is, like, I don't know, 10 minutes, 15 minutes in the walk, you'd be like, hey, there's a patch of grass. Now's a good time to go pee and poop. And then you would just tell your dog to go pee and poop. Give your dog whatever, 6 feet of leash. Let them go pee or poop. If they don't have to right away, go back to a structured walk. But a lot of dogs, like, will actually stop, put on the brakes, drop trowel, go right there on the cement as well. So, yeah, but you can absolutely, when I say structured walk, that doesn't mean like you're never allowed to go to the bathroom. So, next.
My dog breaks out of her metal cage when we leave. She bends the bars only when we are gone.
So, Lisa, you probably need a stronger crate, and you can use a remote collar to stop that. A lot of people struggle with this. So, a lot of people struggle with the concept of punishing a dog in a crate that's trying to break out of it because it's going to make the dog afraid. Number one, no, it won't. Number two, your dog could die or injure itself if it breaks out of a crate. So what I want you to do is this. You set up a video camera. You have the remote collar on the dog. I do this all the time. I've done this personally probably over 250 times, and my videos have been seen by millions. I think we're up to like 5 million people. It's not a huge amount of people, but about 5 million people. Tons of people listen to this show. I had a radio show for 6 years. This is not ego brag stuff, but I've given this advice out so many times, and I would say it's 99% successful, at least. Video camera, dog in crate, leave your house, go down one house. You have a quarter mile on the remote collar. Dog starts trying to get out of the crate, make it suck. Yep, make it uncomfortable. How high? High enough that the dog stops. What does the dog do? The dog goes, that sucked. So if I was sitting in this room and that door was closed and every time I reached the door and I got a shock, I wouldn't open that door anymore. And then every time I tried to open up one of these windows, I got a shock, open up the windows anymore. What would I do? I'd probably sit down in this chair. I'd probably go fall asleep. I'd lay down on the ground. Just think about this. It works. It works. It doesn't make the dog more afraid. It doesn't make the dog scared. You don't ruin the relationship with your dog. Now you're ruining your relationship with your dog. Dog breaks out of the freaking crate, gets thousands of dollars in damage. You got to go to the vet. You get the bill, and you get a $2,500 bill. You want to talk about ruining a relationship with a dog? It's like, hey, you fucking dog, you just cost me $2,500. That's a great way to ruin a relationship with a dog. So giving it a split-second correction, no.
Hey, you fucking dog.
Sorry. Did I jump in that file? Sorry. Sorry, guys.
Hey, you fucking dog. Next. Oh, I can't stop saying it.
Next.
That's going to be my new catchphrase. How many T3 do you guys plan on doing in 2018?
Probably three. February is already announced in Chatsworth, California, two in Rhode Island. I'm going to be doing two in Rhode Island, one in California. Thanks for all the super hearts, folks. Thanks.
Should I use the e-collar to correct whining or ignore that as long as he is ignoring other dog?
Do not whine button. Remote collar. Next.
Dog is terrified of storms. Any advice to help her?
Oh, Big Wayne, what a pain in the ass, isn't it? I know. This is what you can do. This sounds so cruel. This is what I do. Some people will tell you to use different essential oils. I will not discount essential oils. I don't do that. What I do is this. If my dogs are afraid of storms, and as long as they're in place, I let it go. If my dog is running around frantically, I stop that. So what I do is this. I stop the physical action of my dog, and I put them in a spot. And if they're going to be afraid, I'll have them work through it, but in a spot. Does that make sense? So get rid of all the frantic stuff, jumping up on the couch, even hiding underneath the couch, jumping on the bed, trying to get out of the kennel. Stop all the movement, and then help them work through it. It sucks. Next.
I don't remember what this was, Sean's question. Yep, have Sean, I tried it? We'll yep, try more.
Yep.
My dog is not fazed by prong collar. What am I doing wrong?
Angela, hold on. Let me just ask this question. Listen, your fearful dog that is terrified of reactive dogs will do great. Okay, let me just explain my seminars because I do these all over the world. You will not have the worst behaved dog there. No dog that comes there is well behaved. Most dogs that come there are anxious, reactive, aggressive, don't know any commands, jump on their owners, are a big pain in the ass, and bark too much. People drive up to 36 hours. They fly from other states. I've had people come from other countries. Your life will change at this weekend seminar. Come, if you're thinking about it, come to the seminar. And I'm not saying this to sell tickets. I'm saying this because I want your life to change. I truly do. It will change. Yeah, so bring your reactive, fearful dog to the seminar. It will do better than it's ever done, ever. Guaranteed. Guaranteed. Linda's not at the seminars. She might bring the kids. Next.
No, if there's food.
If there's food. Next.
My dog is not fazed by prong collar. What am I doing wrong?
So, Angela, what I want you to do, Angela, is remember, the prong collar is just a tool. So you're probably doing the training wrong. That's not a shaming, blaming thing. You're probably doing the training wrong. So I need to know more about it. So I need to know more about what's going on. You can do a free Skype with me. You can try to write it here. But what I would do is I'd go back to my do-it-yourself videos. And also I would go back to my do-it-yourself videos and start all over again. But do a free Skype with me first because you might be just doing something incorrect. Next.
Do you still offer a shadow program? Can only find T3 on your info on your website? Yes, I
do a shadow. Just go to the website, Sally Canine Training. What I want you to do is I want you to fill out a contact form. Just put in shadow. Next.
Good evening, Linda and Jeff. I'm glad you're feeling 100% better, Linda. Thank you so much.
She was a wreck Saturday. Next.
Yeah. what if your dog is fearful? No.
Yep. Sarah, you'll have a great time at the seminar. Next. Seminar, you can go to rvdogtrainer.com. rvdogtrainer.com.
How to desensitize a dog to 4th of July. I am anti-drug unless I have to. Do I have to?
No, you don't have to. Julie, what I want you to do right now is we talked about this. We talked about place, right? Place command. And then what I want you to do is start soundtracks right now. download all kinds of sounds from soundtracks. They also make a good one for police horses. And also they make some for working horses through New York City streets of tons of different sound effects, but you can get firework sound effects, start them low and start increasing them high. You can do clicker and food for all that stuff as well. Next.
New here, where is the seminar?
I do them all over the world, literally all over the world. But we're talking, if you go to rvdogtrainer.com, like I just mentioned, you'll be able to see them all. Next.
Any seminars in or near Alberta, Canada?
Spokane, Washington, which hasn't been announced yet. It's going to be announced soon. Next.
Someone just asked about that.
Yep.
I am going to your seminar in Ontario next year.
Yep.
We have a reactive APBT rescue.
Okay, so you have a reactive dog. Stop calling it a rescue dog. All dogs are rescue dogs. Every one of my dogs is a rescue dog, even the ones that I bought. So number one, and I just say that not to be shame on you. I say it because what it is a lot of us, you sometimes throw the rescue word out there, and it keeps us from doing our best work and actually asking the dog to do its best work, because what we do is we have this story in our head. So it also doesn't make a difference that it's a bully breed. It's just other than it's a little bit stronger than other dogs. So a reactive dog is what I want you to do is teach it how to properly walk on a leash. I've got videos on how to do that. Remote collar heel is going to be the best. So remote collar heel training your dog to walk properly next to you and not be reactive eliminates reactivity 95%. So that's what I want you to do. So try that for starters. But also, it's bigger than that. There's hundreds of things you should be doing in your day as far as the way you live your life with your dog. Next.
Your dogs are gorgeous. Which breeder were they imported from?
Oh, thanks. One of them is from a breeder in Connecticut. They're both from Czech line dogs, and then one was from a breeder that's over in it's from a military thing. So people can't get dogs from there other than military folks. But I had an in. I got a Navy SEAL in, so. But there's plenty of good dogs out there. I would stay away from Germany, and I would look in the Czech Republic. If you like to look at my dogs, look at the Czech Republic. Next, but you got to go over there to find them, or send somebody over there that you trust. Don't go by the videos, and don't go by photos. Mm. Or there are good ones in the United States. There are some good ones in the United States. Next.
I like how these girls are smaller. Looking forward to Providence seminar.
Awesome. Brian, it's going to be a good one.
Sacramento area.
Ooh, Manny, I would love to do a seminar in the Sacramento area. Nothing yet. I would love to do something up there. San Diego is the closest, Denver, Colorado. But I would love to be up in the Sacramento area. Nothing. Find me a place to do it. Find me a training facility, something like that. I'll do it. Next.
Thanks, Jeff. You've convinced me to attend seminar in Providence, RISD alum.
Oh, Sarah. Oh, nice. Sarah, you'll have a great time. You will have a good time. And just remember, just breathe before you walk in. But I'm telling you, everybody walks in thinking they got the worst dog and they're all nervous. And it's no different. It's no different. It's like clockwork there. It's like clockwork. And the Providence one is a smaller one because it's where we have our training center. Because people have access to our company all the time in Providence. So the seminar here is not as big. When I travel around the world, the seminars are way bigger, 30, 40, 50, 60 people, because they don't have access to me. So next.
When you come to Ellenton, Florida, can bring sister with both our GSDs. They are litter mates.
Awesome. Yeah, I've got two seminars in Ellenton. Next.
Will you ever go to Oregon?
I would love to go to Oregon. I would love to go to every single state. So, but no seminars lined up for Oregon. Next.
I didn't realize how far my GSD had come with your training until I dog sat two untrained retrievers.
Nick, ain't it? The bar in the United States, I have an international audience here where people from 90 countries watch this show. The bar in the US is so freaking low that most people don't know what a trained dog is. In fact, when I go like this, you know what I get? I get bored and sad and tired. Nobody ever says trained. Bored, sad, tired. Nobody ever says trained. So right now, if we wanted to go swimming literally in the ocean for an hour and a half to 2 hours, they would go. If we wanted to play chuck it for an hour, they would do it. If we wanted to strap them, me get onto a bike and we would go for a 12-mile run, they would do it. But for some reason, bored, sad, and tired are the first three words that usually comes out of my mouth. Nobody ever says trained, which is cool. That's fine. Job security. You know, next.
It's a great time. You'll be so glad you went. That's right, Heather.
Oh, thanks, Heather. Heather's been. And she's got a little tiny dog. Next.
Nothing.
Right. Awesome. Oh, cool. So ask your questions. Give your hearts. Share this. Join this.
Oh, here we go. My dog and I still have things to work on, reactivity, but I really feel like she's a super great dog.
Yeah, you know what? This is the thing. I got things to work on, too. Do you know what I mean? So I got things to work on with my dogs. My dogs aren't perfect at all. I got issues. You know what I mean? I got issues. You know, this is the thing. I think us as humans and then us as the caretaker of our animals, we're always moving forward. We're always moving forward. There's always things we can do. I got 30 of those freaking friends today. Next.
That's it right now.
So you can go to solidcaninetraining.com. That's the company that we have up in Providence, Rhode Island. I've got three awesome trainers. We did a trick training for kids class. Oh, you know what we're doing now? Finally, I just posted up three trick training videos. Everybody would want to do trick training videos. I'm charging for them because it's totally different than what we normally do. Also, like, I do need to make money, you know. So what you're going to do is you can go to my Facebook page. I just posted a link for all three trick training videos that we've got, and you can actually buy them. They're like $2.99 or something like that. Next.
Hi from Brisbane, Australia.
Oh, hey, Brisbane, Marco. I'm trying to do a – I was up in Cairns and then Port Douglas last year. I'm trying to do a seminar in Brisbane. I love it in Brisbane.
I want to come to Ellenton but can't afford both days. How can I decide?
Do you mean both seminars? Because the seminar is 2 days. It's a Saturday-Sunday. It's a Saturday-Sunday seminar. What I would do is – nine, here. Good. So what I would do is if you go to the first one, you get a discount off the second one. Because if you're talking about the first – I would go to the depends on the skills. You can do you go to the remote collar one. That might be the best one for you if you're interested in that. I don't know. The first one's good also. It's a hard one. Email me and we'll talk about it. Next.
The pointer even even scared at times to – sorry, guys. To drink from water bowl, anything new he comes across.
Yeah, a lot of dogs are afraid of that. Some dogs, if your dog has dog tags on and it hits the water bowl, that freaks them out a lot, just an FYI. Dogs just, you know, what I would do is this, is you can start doing, the water bowl is not the issue. So we have to raise the dog's confidence a lot of other ways. Also, this isn't a shaming, blaming kind, you know, comment. A lot of owners make it worse. A lot of owners make it worse. They actually reinforce the fear of the dogs because they're trying to use soft energy. That doesn't mean you want to be mean to the dog, but a lot of owners reinforce dogs' fear because they feel they shouldn't hold their dog accountable because the dog's, like, afraid of things. So next.
How to say no, don't pet my dog to children and teens.
Just like that. Julie, just like that. Hand out, don't pet my dog. And if they get closer, push them away. Next.
Give me trained any day. Manic and uncontrollable sucks.
I know, Nick. You're right. Agreed.
Yes, I missed it. Can't wait until you come to Brisbane.
I know, Marco. I know. I'm trying to. Next.
Can you suggest somewhere to stay with a dog for Providence?
Kimberly, I would check some Airbnbs. So go to Airbnb and then check off the pet friendly thing and then do a search. My Airbnb that's pet friendly is booked. You can't do that one. La Quinta Inn allows pets. The Dean Hotel allows pets. A lot of the extended stay hotels allow pets. So what I would do is I would go into go to Expedia if you want to. Just type in pet friendly or pet friendly places to live. A lot of the places change the rules a lot. So next.
When is a good age to train puppy? Have an extremely mouthy dingo mix.
The second you get the dog. Literally the second. So the monks of Newski start training their dogs at 3 days old. to 3 days old, they start training their dogs. So it's the minute, the second you get that dog, you are trained. You already are training your dog. Your dog is trained. So whenever you pick up your dog, whether you pick it up from a breeder or a rescue or for someone's house for rehoming, you're training your dog. Literally the way you took your dog into your car was training. Everything you said, what you put it in, your thoughts, your feelings, your energy, always, always training. Every day, 24/7, you're training your dog. So you're either reinforcing what you want or you're reinforcing what you don't want. So I've got all these great videos on YouTube that you can watch, and it'll help you with training what you do want and also eliminating problem behaviors. And then obviously also through this Q&A, you can also get more. And then you can also do free Skype stuff for me, or you can hire me. But I always say that last because I don't do these free scopes to you know drum up business, even though this is a business for me. Next.
You have helped me with his entire life.
Oh, Rich. Awesome. Thank you, buddy.
Do not pet vests or just tell them no, he's in training. I do it all the time.
Yeah, Casey, awesome suggestion. I'm telling you, man, them freaking do not pet vests are like a magnet to pet your dog. They really are. They really are. You can literally have a white cane with a red tip with a lab or a German Shepherd with a harness with a stiff arm, dark glasses with a cane in front of you, and freaking assholes are gonna want to pet your dog. So the best thing to do is literally be a bitch, be an asshole, and say no. Now, if you ask me politely, can I pet your dog? Thank you for asking. No, you can't. I will always be kind and gentle to you, always. But if you reach in, if you reach in, all games are off. Sorry, you're a dick. Get out of my way. And I'm a nice guy, but it's just like you're rude, and you're gonna get bit one day.
Someone says it's like the please use other door sign.
Right, right.
How do I increase recall motivation? Food and toys not doing anything once he's on a scent.
So Marco, remote collar. Next.
Oh, stim is his motivation and no stim is his reward.
So increase the stim. Increase the stim, buddy. So.
Thanks, Jeff and Linda. I really enjoy your perspective on life and life with dogs. Very, very helpful.
Oh, thanks, Jill. Also, if you might have still, there was another eclipse last night and it's on my Instagram stories. If you're not on my Instagram stories, you might want to get on my Instagram stories because get on my Instagram stories. So if you're on Instagram.
Body tonight with the dogs. Hey, if you guys missed the clips, check it out. It's about to happen again.
No. Get out of my Instagram stories. Next.
I don't trust dogs at the vet. Hold on.
You better get on my Instagram stories. It's going to. Yeah, Instagram stories is it eliminates after 24 hours. Next.
I don't trust dogs at the vet. They're not trained. But why does this keep doing this?
But can't avoid vet business.
Thank
yep.
you. But can't avoid vet business.
Yep.
I bought the Sit Pretty Trick video, working obedience foundation first, but excited to try later.
Awesome. Thank you.
Dean Hotel is great and allows pets.
Thank awesome.
You, Heather. Hi, guys. Ontario, Canada.
Hey, Yvonne. How are you? I'll be up there soon. Father's Day weekend. Fergus.
What? Another eclipse?
Yep.
It's not.
Yep.
It's not.
Don't blow up my spot. It freaking is an eclipse.
Ow. I thought you were going to show your butt or something.
No.
All right. Ow. Looking for a pup-friendly hotel Airbnb for the seminar in South Carolina. Fingers crossed so we can come.
Casey, they have them. They have them. You can also board your dog at Astro Kennels, but there's definitely dog-friendly hotels because that's a bigger seminar. About 40 people come to that seminar. It'd be great to have you down there.
Nick saw your eclipse.
See? Nick saw it. Don't blow up my spot. Don't stop. Please stop.
What one is this? Uh-huh. I see what's happening. I'll check out this eclipse. Yep.
Thank you.
You guys are cute.
Yep. Instagram stories. I put a lot of stuff on there. What else do we put stuff on? Facebook. There's a ton of stuff on Facebook.
I saw it too. Funny. Yep. Just a funny guy.
That's from the Airbnb guest that's coming in. All right. What else we got? Sarah. Sarah definitely saw it. Sarah's a faithful watcher. Good. That was a good show.
Still have time.
We do? Oh, we do. We still got time.
Okay, here we go. Familiar with Virginia-based off-leash canine training, getting two e-collars and orientation from them September 2nd.
Rob, I don't comment on other trainers. That's the thing. I don't comment on other trainers other than my buddy Sean O'Shea from The Good Dog, because he's a colleague of mine, and we do seminars together. And then Tori Smith from Take the Lead Canine Training down in Florida, because she does a seminar with me as well. But other than that, I don't comment on other trainers at all. So that's the problem. That's the thing. So with all the, you know, good or bad, you know, I just don't. Like, I don't comment on articles. I don't comment on, like, I don't let people post stuff on my page. It's just, you know, but, you know, that's not a bad thing. You know what I mean? Yep.
You ready next for the question? Yep. Dog in a down or place, do you correct the anxious panting or only the whining?
When what?
Dog in a down or place, do you correct the anxious panting or only the whining?
The anxious panting is a rough one. I have absolutely gotten rid of the movement of anxiety into a down position, the whining, and then I've gone after the panting. And then I get that. Next.
Haha, my Aussie harness on with no pet in training at Home Depot. Three men had, I don't know.
Sabrina, we're missing something.
Had stuck their face in his.
Yeah, I know. So here's a great example. So no petting, but you'll stick your face in the dog. Yeah, people are just stupid. People are stupid. Yes.
What is the funniest moment in training you had?
Julie, the funniest? I don't know. I mean.
Remember that one time?
I've worked with 4,000 dogs. I mean, I'd have to think about that. I'd have to really think about that. I've had a ton of fun, and I still have fun. Next.
You gotta think about that. That's a good
one, Julie. Yep. Julie, I'm not keeping it from you. It's not like I'm like, ooh, I know what it was. That was a joke when Linda said, you remember that one? That's how she jokes. So this is the thing. This is the thing. Like it's not like I know it and I'm keeping it from you. I would tell you. So
but what about that other time?
Stop it. See, that's her joking. Next.
I'm a funny person.
You are.
If I were, I would say that. I'm using off-leash canine training in Ohio. Since I'm not you, I'll say it's good. Not as good as Jeff. I am.
And then this is the thing. It's like, and keep in mind that it's a franchise, so there'll be different. There's like anything else. Next.
We need a harness that reads, "We'll bite your face."
You know, this is the thing. This is the thing about. I've seen dogs with muzzles on, and someone will say, "Why does your dog have a muzzle?" And they've been said because the dog bites, and then the person says, "Can I pet your dog?" I mean, obviously, with a muzzle on, it can't bite, but that's the level of incompetence that unfortunately some people are working with. They're not thinking; they just don't think. It's a selfish act. The act of wanting to pet someone's dog is a selfish act. We have to remember that. So, going down to its core base, it's a very selfish act for a human to want to pet another dog. So what happens is when you tell them no, you're taking away their happiness. They really don't care about you or the dog. So they only care about their own happiness. That's why they are so forceful on you. Next.
Y'all have good advice on your shows.
Thanks, Kim.
No problem going to use your pressure on-off philosophy regardless. You two enjoy your evening.
Thanks, Rob. Thanks.
Wanda hooked me up where to get a dressage whip. I'm getting it tomorrow.
All right, Sue. Yeah, you can get one at Tractor Supply or any tack shop. Next.
Because of what I learned from you, I am training others prong and e-collar.
Oh, Rich, awesome. Nice. Proud of you.
should write a book about your funnies?
Sabrina, I mean, I don't know if I could write a book about my funnies. I got great experiences, but I don't even know a lot of funnies. I mean, I laugh a lot when I train, but it's usually when a dog's trying to bite me. You know, those are pretty funny moments in my opinion. So, but if you go to my seminars, if you've been to one of my seminars, there's a lot of funny stuff that goes on. We laugh a lot.
I'm just wondering, has anything ever happened? Like, have you got peed on or like, I don't know, like something funny like that?
Yeah, I've gotten peed on before at a seminar. Yeah. Next.
Jeff actually got stumped on a question. I know. Yep. Have you had a dog completely flip out when you were using bark collar on them?
Elizabeth, yeah, turn it down. Yep, turn it down. Or switch to a remote collar so you have more control over it. Next.
Oh, and Rich says, and I said I would never use prong long ago.
I know, Rich, until you actually found out. Rich, my buddy Sean O'Shea just did a seminar, a video on that. It's like people have all these opinions on things, but they've actually never seen them. They've never either seen the item in person or seen how they work or understood how they work, but they already have an opinion on it without knowing. It's like never having sushi and saying, I don't like sushi. It's like, how do you know that? Well, I just know I wouldn't like it. Like, but how do you know that? Like, so it's the same thing with dog training equipment. Like, you know, remote collars are bad. How do you know? Because they must be. It's like, how do you know that? Like, you've never used one or seen one used. Well, they shock dogs. I'm like, well, maybe that's not what they do. But even if they did, that might not be the worst thing. Like if your dog's about to swallow something from the counter, like definitely don't want to like say good boy. Next.
I love you guys. This is a funny Q&A tonight.
Oh, thanks, Lindsay. We've had some really funny Q&As. That's for sure.
Did you realize Optimus Prime parked at the side of you at McGee's? Did Optimus Prime? I got to check the photos of McGee's.
Wait, hold on. There was nobody parked next to us in the parking lot. And then...
Parked. Maybe.
Nick, do you mean, if you're being serious about this, were they in the two motorhomes? They were a little bit away from us?
We got to check our phone.
Was there a tractor trailer? Anyway, next.
Linda, are you doing Periscopes? I will be doing Periscopes again. As a matter of fact, I think I'm going to be scheduling my Periscopes for Sunday nights. I don't know what time yet. Probably 8:30 p.m. Eastern time.
Nice. In the morning? No. In the morning?
This morning?
This morning? No, it's a truck stop. No, I'll check. I'll check the check. Next.
Excessive doorbell delivery man barking. Should I train impulse control to not bark at all?
Yes, not impulse control. Just train the dog to shut the hell up. Next.
Your seminar training contract requires a Bordetella vaccine. Not even sure what that is.
Bordetella is for kennel cough. It's for kennel cough, Sarah. So it's you can go to the vet. They do it up the nose, or go to Tractor Supply. Buy it yourself. Buy yourself a Tractor Supply for $5.67 or something like that. It's your dropper goes up the nose. You can get the injection or you can get this. It's like the kennel cough. You know, any dog where there's a lot of dogs around, whether it's in a grooming place, a doggy daycare, a boarding place. You know, they.
But it's highly contagious.
Yeah,
that's why you need it.
That's why you need it. Next.
Correction while panting in a down place makes him get up and readjust. How to clarify?
Marco, make it lower. Make it lower. Maybe order oral Bordetella. There you go. Next.
Put a sound bar on dog collar that starts growling when people reach hands forward would be awesome.
Yeah.
Hello from Kenora, Ontario.
Oh, hey, Kenora. What's up?
Told the guy at HD that my Aussie bites kids in the face. He said, good, I'm not a child. Idiot.
That's why, Sabrina. That's why. You're better off just saying no.
Thinking of starting a neighborhood pack walk with balanced dogs. Good idea.
Masterful Moms, great idea.
It's awesome.
Document it so other people can do it. Literally show and explain how you did it. Make YouTube videos on it. Blog about it. Go crazy. Absolutely, Masterful Moms.
Like a blooper reel, have rolling camera 24/7.
Yep.
That would be fun.
Next. Yep.
What do you use a dressage whip for?
Dawn, for dog pack socialization, you'll see us with dressage whips. It's a great way to give a dog a correction in the butt. Quick pat. You're not beating the dog. Quick tap in the butt if it starts getting adrenalized, gets overly aroused, starts doing bad behavior. It's also a great way to advocate for dogs for space. So say you're working with a really nervous, fearful dog, and a couple of dogs come up to that dog. You can take the dressage whip, put it down in front of the dog, and literally just, it's like a shepherd's stick, and just ask the other dogs without using words to move away. So it's a fantastic training tool. Next.
I was in Vista.
Awesome. Vista's coming up again, Sabrina, right? Yeah, Vista's coming up.
That was excellent. A good Sean piece.
Yes, it was really good, Denise. I know.
Would a solid place be the best approach for reactivity to postman, delivery man, etc.? Plus structure.
Jackie, yes, but also you got to punish for the barking. Next.
Like, I just know I don't like apple pie.
Exactly.
It's just like that.
Yep.
11-week GSD puppy does not stop biting. We have tried what you have recommended before, except Ecollar.
Try the bonker. Try the bonker. So, 11-week-old puppy, it's going to bite. It's going to bite for a couple more weeks. Yep. Next.
Dog e-collar training, good leadership. Previously bit two kids, one adult. Now bit owner two times. Thoughts?
Thoughts, there's way too many variables to give you a proper answer.
And the rescue wants euthanasia.
Oh.
Dog is Jekyll and Hyde, unpredictable.
So this is the thing. Of course the rescue wants euthanasia. This is the thing. I would never, ever, ever recommend that a dog die through Periscope, let alone on the phone, until I've actually worked the dog. I wouldn't know. So, you know, but rescues are in a rough place. There's an ethics issue to, you know, are they willing to adopt out a known biting dog? It's an ethics issue. I'm not saying they should or they shouldn't. I'm saying that's a question, though, that needs to be asked, and that's a question that should be addressed. So, next. That doesn't mean it can't be fixed, but I'm not working the dog, and I don't know who is working the dog. You know, next.
How's the groomer doing in the new space?
I think the groomer's doing pretty well. You know, I think the groomer's doing pretty well. Heather, bring your dogs down and have her groom them. Next.
Heather does her own dogs.
Oh. Next.
I don't know.
I thought just San Diego when you. Now, San Diego, if you're talking about San Diego, huh? I don't know. I'll be in San Diego. Next.
She's been adopted three times with top trainer working with her.
Oh, okay. You know, again, top trainer, that doesn't, you know.
I don't have any more questions.
Yeah, again, this is the thing. There's a lot of variables out there. So any dog will bite in the right circumstances. Any dog. Any dog will bite in the right circumstances. If you put enough pressure on a dog, they're going to bite. Very rarely do you find a dog that doesn't bite in high, high stress with a lot of pressure. But a lot of dogs, especially even a rehabbed biting dog, no matter who trained that dog, you know, pressure. What's pressure? It could be simple as reaching out to pet the dog. So it's a lot of stuff. Take care, Marco.
We're over.
Oh, shit, we're over. When I checked your site, no Vista Clinic. Has that changed? No, it shouldn't have. We should be in Vista. I hope it's up there. I'll have to go take a look. Unless something happened. I hope it's up there because we need to sell tickets. I'll take a look tonight. I'll find out. Let me ask Amanda. All right, everybody. We got to go. It's been over an hour. Thank you, everybody.
See you later.
Take care. Madly in love with all of you, too. Honored and blessed to be able to share. Take care.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.